Hello, my dear friends, welcome back to RMK Resolutions. Now, from this particular video, we are going to start the specific examples of the pest or agricultural pest, important agricultural pest. And first, we are going to start with the jowar stem borer. So this is a very important agricultural pest because they are going to harm the different important economically important plants, or we can say the crop. So by this particular pest, or we are going to study with reference to the identification mark, how this particular pest we are going to identify, then nature of the damage and how we are going to control this particular pest. So control measures we have also look. So on your screen you can see the jowar stem borer, the class, this is the classification, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, then family Pyralidae, genus Chilo, and species Zonellus. So this one is the systematic position of jowar stem borer. So remember, genus Chilo and species Zonellus. So as I told you, this particular jowar, this is the most important food crop in the Maharashtra state. So this is the food which are going to provide for the many people. So it supplies the food for the people also, and it also supplies the very good fodder for the different cattle also. We are talking about the jowar, so it is also the food for the cattle. So this particular jowar, it is cultivated in the kharif and rabi season, and it also cultivated in the hot weather. So this particular jowar stem borer, it is the major pest of the jowar crop. So this particular pest, it is observed in the early growth of the crop and even after the this particular plant formation. So mostly they are found before to the growth of the plant. So this pest, jowar stem borer, it is active throughout the year. It is active throughout the year, but the infection is more noticed in the hot environment. So there are different hybrid varieties are available now, and these hybrid varieties are more susceptible to these plant. So on your screen you can see, this is the jowar stem borer, and these, we can say this one is the different stages or developmental stages of jowar stem borer. Now this on your left hand side of the screen, here we notice the eggs, then this one is the larva, this one is the larva inside the stem, and see, this is the larva inside the stem, and these are the adults, D and E. It shows the adult jowar stem borer. So first we'll see the distribution of this particular jowar stem borer. So jowar stem borer, it occurs throughout the India. Jowar stem borer, it is commonly called as the spotted stalk borer, or it is also known as pink borer. So when we see about the identification mark of this particular jowar stem borer on your screen, you can see jowar stem borer, it is the Chilo partalis. So this particular, first it is very important to understand the identification marks. So on your screen, this is the adult moth. So adult moth, it is medium size insect which is grow up to the 3 cm wingspan. these are the fore wings and these are the hind wings. So wingspan is near about 3 cm. So this fore wings are straw or light brown in color. We can see here fore wings. These are the light brown in color with numerous brown spots on the margin. You can observe here. These are the numerous spot. We can easily observe here also on the margin of the forewing. There are brown spots are observed, and hind wing it is whitish in color and it is very papery. It is very thin and papery. So these are the identification mark in the adult. So when we look at the caterpillar, or we can say the larva, here on your screen, this is the life cycle of the jawar stem borer. So when we look at the larva, so larva, it is dirty white in color. You can clearly observe it is dirty white in color with brown head. This one is the head. So this is the brown head with mandibulate type of mouth part. So many dark spots are appeared on the body surface of the larva. Then mature caterpillar or mature larva, it is measured up to 12 to 20 centimeter in length, and this shows the 4 broad patchy strips on the body surface. You can see here, or you can see here also, these are the 4 broad patchy strips are found on the body surface of mature caterpillar. Here also there are some images of caterpillar. You can see here, these are the caterpillar which having a brown head, and they grow up to 10 to 20 mm. So jawar stem borer larva on your screen, which infect the maize plant. They make a tunnel inside the maize plant, and that is unfit for the feeding to the cattle also. So as I told you, the host plant of this pest is the jawar, major pest of the jawar and maize. So mainly they are going to infect to the jawar as well as the here this is the sorghum plant which is infected by the jawar stem borer. So we can see here they make a hole in the this particular sorghum plant, and this is unfit for the eating for the cattle. So host plant is the jawar and maize, but they also recorded to infect to the bajri, ragi and some other grasses, but main host plant is the jawar and maize. Now we are trying to understand the life cycle of the jawar stem borer or Chilopertalis. Chilo is the genus name and Pertalis is the species name. So life cycle, it begins with the eggs. Female, they lay the eggs up to 50 to 300 eggs, and these particular eggs are laid in a cluster. You can see here, these are the eggs laid in a cluster, and they are arranged in a 2 rows under the surface of the leaves. So these particular eggs are found under the surface of the leaves, and they are arranged in a 2 to 3 rows during the April and May. So we know that this particular pest, they occur in the hot environment. So when we look at the egg morphology, then eggs are creamy white in color, and they hatch into the young caterpillar or larva about 6 days of incubation period. So after 6 days of the incubation period, that egg, they hatches and they become a larva. Then this particular larva or young caterpillar, they feed on the tender leaves for 1 or 2 days. First, these larvae, they feed on the tender leaves. Tender leaves means those are the fresh, or we can say small leaves. These leaves are the food material for this larva. And after that, they bore into the central shoot. Now see here, this particular larva, they enter into the center part of the shoot. So larva stages is about 3 to 4 weeks. This is the time period for the larva stage. It is near about 3 to 4 weeks and have normally 5 molt. So larva, they undergo molting. Molting means they shed their skin. So 4 to 5 molts takes place for this larva. So as I told you, this particular 5 molting of larva takes place, and after that pupation stage is begins, that is from larva to pupa. So pupation takes place inside the stem. Pupation takes place inside the stem, and that pupation stage, it lasts about 7 to 10 days. And after that, this larva pupa become a adult. So adult, they lives for 2 to 4 days only. So the pest generally active from June to November, and about 4 generation they completed in a 1 year. So this particular pest, they hibernate in the larval stage in a short during the unfavorable period. So when there is unfavorable period, then that larva become a hibernate, that is the inactive in the during the unfavorable season. So this is about the life cycle of chilo, or we can say jawar stem borer. Now let's see the nature of damage of this jawar stem borer. Can see here also, and here also, this one is the nature of damage, how this particular larva, they are going to damage the jawar plant or maize plant. So as I now we have learned the life cycle. So newly hatched caterpillar or newly hatched larva, that is those larva which are coming from the eggs, they initially feed on the leaves, as I already told you, and then they make a small hole in the leaf lamina. First of all, they make a small hole in the leaf of the lamina, and then they attack all the parts of jawar plant except the root. They attack everywhere except the root, the particular larva they attack. So larva, they entering into the leaf, they entering into the hole, and they cut the leaves, which on emergence, and they make a hole, pinhole, they make a hole into the shoots, and they longitudinally form a streak in the shoot. So when they enter into the shoot, then drying the central shoot takes place. Central shoot get dried, and formation of dead heart takes place. So as I told you, dead heart formation takes place. So you can see here, this one is dead heart. Dead heart means it is actually that plant get died. So when larva is enter into the shoot, and they absorb everything, they eat everything inside the shoot. So central part of the shoot, it get dried. So larva bore into the shoot, and they feed on the internal tissue of the jawar or maize, and they cause the typical dead heart symptom. So the larva is enter into the stem, they feed on the tissue, that is the pith, and the tunnel or galleries form inside the shoot. So this is about the nature of damage of jawar stem borer. You can see here, this we have seen, they make a hole or they make a tunnel inside the sorghum or jawar and maize. and they ultimately make a dead heart. So larva is the most damageable for this plant. Now we are trying to understand the control measure of this particular jawar stem borer. So first method is the hand picking of the adult moth. Adult moth is directly pick from the that particular plant and collect that particular moth, and it get killed by the different chemicals. Then light trapping method of the adult moths are also used to control. Then collection of the eggs is also the control method for the destruction of jawar stem borer. So eggs are collected and then it get destroyed. Then burning of the stubble. So those particular part of the jawar which is infected, directly burn that particular part, so infection is not spread to the next crop. Then changing the sowing and harvesting time, it also reduce the infection. This is again a very important strategy. So changing the sowing pattern and harvesting timing, it also reduce the infection. Then next method for control this jawar stem borer is the crop rotation in another cultural practice that does not allow the pest of one crop to survive next year for lack of it. Also changing the crop rotation is again a method for the controlling this pest. Then growing the resistance varieties of the jawar, growing the resistance variety of the jawar. So which one, which resistance varieties we can use? That is the CH7, this is the resistance variety. Then CH8, this one is also the resistance variety. Then there are different IS5566, then IS5285, then IS5613. These are the some resistance varieties. So grow this particular resistance variety so pest unable to act on the plant. So this is the some methods which are used to control the jawar stem borer. Then there are some chemical methods are also there for controlling the jawar stem borer. So jawar, there are some spraying of the 0.05% pindane or different pesticides are used to control the jawar stem borer, or 0.1% endosulfan is used to control the jawar stem borer on 50 days old plant. So there, these are some chemical methods, and some biological methods are also used to control the jawar stem borer. Okay, so this is about the full strategies. So we discussed this particular jawar stem borer in several parts of our discussion. So I summarize this particular things. So first we discuss about the systematic position of the jawar stem borer. Then we discuss the distribution pattern of this jawar stem borer. Then next we find the identification marks, how this particular jawar stem borer is identified by using the this wing size, wing color, that is a brown color. Here there is a dotted brown pattern on the margin of the four wings. Then hind wings, these are the light whitish in color, papery in color. So these are the some identification marks. Then we also observe the larva, how these larvas are identified. This is the brownish head. Then some strips are found on the body surface of the jawar stem borer. And we also observe, okay, this one is the caterpillar or larva of the jawar stem borer. So this is a brownish head, and these are the some strips are found over there. And it is also in the identification marks, here we can also observe the eggs laying pattern. Eggs are laid in a cluster and they are arranged in a two rows. So we learn about the identification marks of the Java stem borer. Then we also learn about the life cycle of the Java stem borer, the nature of damage, how they are going to damage to the maize and Java plants. And we also seen the control measures of the Java stem borer. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like the video, then please like, share this video and subscribe RMK Resolutions. Thank you. Bye-bye.